My name is John Ashon Okasa. I'm praying today for all Ghanaians. Today is 6 March, and I give thanks to the Almighty God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty. I want Ghanaians to know that we are suffering. We Africans, we are suffering because of our evil doing. We don't love each other. Like you can see, Kwame Nkrumah who fight for the independence with guns. Kwame Nkrumah say, if you are okay and your brother is suffering here, then your freedom or your enjoyment is meaningless.
In Africa, our independence is meaningless unless it is linked up with the total liberation of the African continent.
Meaningless. That's why Nkrumah tried to fight for many countries in Africa, like Angola, and etc., etc.
Just the liberation of his beloved Ghana. His life's mission was to oversee the creation of a borderless African superstate in which all the French, British, Spanish, and Portuguese colonies would break free from colonial control and unite under a single Pan-African government. And despite the vast religious, cultural, and ethnic differences of the various nations of Africa, Nkrumah did not see his Pan-African goals as some distant objective to be gradually achieved over the course of several generations. Instead, he was fully convinced that with the right level of political will and dedication, his grand vision could be achieved within his own lifetime. Ghana's capital, Accra, was to become a center of African liberation from which nationalist leaders from all across colonial Africa could come to draw support in their various independence struggles. In his Independence Day address, Nkrumah would proclaim in front of large crowds that Ghana's independence was meaningless if it wasn't linked up with the total liberation of the African continent. And in 1958, he called a meeting of some 300 representatives from all across Africa for the All African People's Conference. Some of a few big names in attendance were Tanzania's Julius Nyerere, Zimbabwe's Joshua Nkomo, Zambia's Kenneth Kaunda, Hastings Banda of Malawi, and Patrice Lumumba of Congo. The event was hugely successful, and in the subsequent years, many of the attendees went on to successfully push for the independence of their respective countries.
I'm not here to tell you your history. If you want to learn history, you have to learn. Brothers and sisters, may God bless all Ghanaians wherever you are. May God give you all your needs, and may God open your mind so that you will stop jealousy and hypocrisy. These are the two things which making we black people, we can't go anywhere. Only few enjoy and many suffer because of greediness. Our leaders know that everybody is talking against African leaders.
By leading members of the CPP. To make matters worse, the award of these contracts was quickly hijacked by corrupt officials, and many key members of Nkrumah's government would grow filthy rich by charging bribes from foreign companies and allowing them to inflate the costs of government projects in exchange for kickbacks and other advantages. And slowly but surely, an Orwellian animal farm society began to emerge, as Ghana's post-independence political elites began exploiting the new nation in much the same way as their colonial predecessors. Pursuing his goal to make Ghana a model socialist society, Nkrumah publicly declared that his government would work towards a complete ownership of the economy by the state. And in pursuit of this goal, he would set up a long list of government ministries and state-owned enterprises. And thanks to this very large and powerful government apparatus, pretty much every aspect of Ghanaian life was placed under the direct or indirect control of one government minister or the other. And with their extensive powers, many of Nkrumah's ministers began treating the resources under their control as their own private property, and a culture of bullying, bribery, and embezzlement would spread from the top to the bottom of Ghanaian society. From job applications to business licenses, and even the award of university scholarships, if you needed to get anything done, you either had to know someone in power or pay someone a bribe. Despite publicly preaching about socialist virtues like solidarity and collective struggle, many of Nkrumah's ministers began flaunting their wealth and living very lavish lifestyles. When questioned about why his wife chose to import a £3,000 gold-plated bed from London, Cabinet Minister Krobo Eduse would respond saying, "Socialism doesn't mean that if you've made a lot of money, you can't keep it." Eduse would later confess to owning 14 houses, a luxurious beachfront property, a long lease on a London flat, several expensive cars, and 6 different bank accounts.
Wake up call. Africa, wake up. Africa, why? Why? Why few people are enjoying and our leaders want poor people to suffer? Why? Why? This is not good. We have to live in harmony. We have to live in social life. Social living is the best. Love your brother and love your sister and do the right thing. Courage, brother. This is the message from Mr. John all his way. I want you people, anybody, if somebody do you something, you don't like it, please call the person and apologize. Just say sorry. Sorry is nothing. You know, sorry is nothing. But don't think you know better than everybody. And Africans, one thing I realize in my fellow Africans is all the time they like to judge people the way they are. A bad people, a jealous people, and kokonsa people are the only ones who normally judge people first. And this is not going to help our economy, and this is not going to help us to grow as in our humanity, you know. Please, I want Africans, especially in Africa, change your character. You think you know much and you know nothing, Africans. I'm not referring to anybody. That's why our leaders know the way we are. That's why they all the time trying to fool us when it comes to campaign election campaign. When it comes to a voting time, then they come and do this, I'll do this, I'll do that, and that.
But they don't want to change. Many people talk, Donald Trump say we live in shithole. Many things, many people come and talk against African leaders. African leaders, why? Why? Only Africa. You can see that we are blessed. See with your eyes. See good. See good. See how people just in the land in Africa. So you can see it's not in anywhere. Only Africa you can see this. Watch and see good with your naked eyes. Anyway, we are celebrating our independence today. So blessing be to everybody who have a good thinking of in brother, and we have to stop biting, and we have to stop hypocrisy, and we have to stop miji. And most of the times we scared to think, and most of the time Africans, we want somebody to come and tell us the way we have to live our life. I will say it again, and I will say it again. Democracy, we don't practice it very well. That's why we are suffering. And you can't take somebody's culture to be your culture. My name once again, Johnny Ashon, all is well, aka Nyongbonyemi. When people hear this, meaning God brother, I don't take this name for myself. Like when somebody call you thief, you can't call yourself thief. Nobody can call himself thief, but somebody will call you thief. So people name people's name. So this is my name. Somebody give it to me. Called Soa, living Teshi. And after I found out that, yes, through my learning, I reached that position. So people call me the brother of God. Or you can call me uncle. Yes, no problem. Ghanaians, thank you very much. Watch Okasa TV.
Abo! Wanyoko mwere makasa kakra. Enzi wanyoko mwene wentiem kakra. Men kase pi. Dame pere makande. Mbakan zbapu kakra. Nemiwe makan mpante. At long last, the battle has ended. And thus, Ghana, your beloved country, is free forever. And yet again, I want to take the opportunity to thank the chiefs and people of this country, the youth, the farmers, the women, who have so nobly fought and won this battle. Also, I want to thank the valiant ex-servicemen who have so cooperated with me in this mighty task of freeing our country from foreign rule and imperialism. And as I pointed out at our Patriot Conference at Sorbonne, I made it quite clear that from now on today, we must change our attitudes, our minds. We must realize that from now on, we are no more a colonial, but a free and independent people. But also, as I pointed out, that also entails hard work. I am depending upon the millions of the country, the chiefs and people, to help me to reshape the destiny of this country. We are prepared to build it up and make it a nation that will be respected by every other nation in the world. We know we are going to have difficult beginnings, but again, I'm relying upon your support. I'm relying upon your hard work. Seeing you in these thousands, it doesn't matter how far my eye goes, I can see that you are here in your millions. And my last warning to you is that you all should stand firm behind us so that we can prove to the world that when the African is given a chance, he can show to the world that he's somebody. We are not waiting. We shall no more go back to sleep anymore. Today, from now on, there is a new African in the world. That new African is ready to fight his own battle and show that, after all, the black man is capable of managing his own affairs. We are going to demonstrate to the world, to the other nations, young as we are, that we are prepared to lay our own foundation. As I said in the assembly just minutes ago, I made it point that we are going to see that we create our own African personality and identity. It's the only way in which we can show the world that we are ready for our own battle. But today, may I call upon you all, that at this great day, let us all remember that nothing in the world can be done unless it has the purported support of God. We have done the battle, and we again rededicate ourselves not only in the struggle to emancipate other territories in Africa. Our independence is meaningless unless it is linked up with the total liberation of the African continent. Let us now, fellow Ghanaians, let us now ask for God's blessing. And for only 2 seconds, in your thousands and millions, I want to ask you to pause only for 1 minute and give thanks to Almighty God for having led us through obstacles, difficulties, imprisonments, hardship and suffering to have brought us to the end of our trouble today. 1 minute silence. Ghana is free forever. And here, I will ask the band to play the Ghana national anthem. Freedom!